A Caldari state is a union of powerful megacorporations governed by a strict meritocracy. The state is a fiercely competitive and ruthless society whose hyper-capitalistic ways have brought its people both misery and triumph.
Calling any convoy Epsilon Minor Kappa survivors. Come in all survivors. Tracking an active training corvette. What is your status? Recruit? Wake up and respond! Just unbelievable. Recruit, what is the last thing you remember? Watching a swarm of drifters warp into your location and tear your fleet apart? Panicking. I bet you remember that. Recruit, my name is Fleet Commander Katara, Caldari Navy. And as of this moment, I am your commanding officer. First things first, we need to figure out what happened here, so I'm lifting your training restrictions and granting you full access to your ship's onboard AI. Say hello to Aura. She'll help you get your ship moving.
Greetings, Captain. I am Aura. I will assist you in commanding your vessel and navigating New Eden. My core logic library has been proven to increase the odds of survival by several orders of magnitude. But I am only capable of advising you. You must make decisions for yourself. Simulations have proven that situational awareness is key to survival. I will now demonstrate how to become aware and alert. Captain, if you close my comms window for any reason, you will be able to recall it through the Operations Info panel by clicking Aura Tips. When you're ready to continue, click Next. To orbit the view around your ship, hold down the left mouse button and move the mouse around. To zoom in or out, scroll your mouse wheel up or down. While you are getting oriented, as you travel through space, I will analyze the objects you encounter. If you discover items that are useful or important, I will highlight those objects in your display. As a demonstration, I have highlighted one of our fleet's wrecks. Let's test basic navigation functions. According to my logs, a Titan-type capital ship in your fleet was destroyed. It would be useful to locate that ship's wreckage and start navigating towards it. A Titan should be the biggest shipwreck that you will be able to find. To set a course for your ship, double-click your mouse's left button anywhere in space. To stop your ship, you should click the highlighted stop button. Using these functions will help you explore the site. Exploration is a vital trait.
You've got to be kidding me. My logs indicate you haven't even graduated from flight school yet. Well, it seems like you're all I've got, so I need you to get to work. Scanners report additional life signals near your location. Your unit was transporting an important research crew. If their research were to be retrieved by drifter patrols, it would be catastrophic for the state. So check the wrecks for potential survivors.
Captain, I have received faint signals from three survivors. To help determine the location of the signal, you should use the look and approach functions of your ship to get closer. Being close will allow you to see what's inside each wreck. To focus your camera on a piece of wreckage, right-click on the wreckage and select the Look At command. Look At is great for inspecting objects in space, but not for piloting. To reset your view, right-click in space and select Look At My Ship. Next, right-click on the wreckage and select the Approach command. We need to get close to the wreckage to extract the survivors, but remember to stop your ship when you are beside the wreckage. To transfer everything from their cargo hold to your own, move your mouse pointer over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents, and then press the Loot All button. After you have clicked the Loot All button, you should close the inventory window using the X in the corner. It's best practice to close windows when you are finished using them. I'm receiving signals that indicate the next survivor is located in the highlighted wreckage. Right-click on the wreckage and select Approach. To transfer the next survivor to your ship, you should repeat the same steps as before. Move your mouse pointer over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents and then press the Loot All button. Excellent, Captain. My scanners indicate one more survivor. Approach the highlighted wreckage. You should now transfer the last survivors to your ship. Don't forget to close the inventory windows after you have finished.
I am Professor Tannen from the Sisters of Eve research team. Thank you for saving my life. The attack was complete carnage. Thousands were killed. Our research on drifter strikes indicates they will likely return to this location to retrieve any survivors. And not for good. I believe the drifters want those survivors for invasive information extraction. It's very invasive. Such information is classified and of great value to the Empire, but since my survival depends on you, I am entrusting you with this.
Recruit, I expected you to be space dust by now. And instead, here you are holding my research scientist. I'll let you in on a little secret. The scientist you just recovered may have information about the source of this incursion. A drifter hive. The presence of a hive in our territory is a major threat. This means it's very high priority to get you and your vessel home safely. The only problem is, the drifters will be looking to rip anything with a pulse out of your ship and take it to their hive. We don't know exactly what happens there, but I doubt it will improve anyone's fortunes. I doubt you noticed, but the drifters raised some sort of warp bubble around your location, so you can't warp out. You're stuck. The generator that created it, however, is close by. Locate and destroy it, and you'll be free to leave. Good fortune.
Captain, in your ship's overview, you can see what your ship's scanners are picking up around you. Find your warp disruption generator in the ship's overview. Then, hold down the left mouse button on the generator, and click Approach on the radial menu. To lock your weapon system on the generator, hold down your left mouse button on the generator and select Lock Target on the radial menu. While engaging, the optimal flight path is to orbit your target. This enables you to move while firing, making it difficult for your enemy's weapon systems to track you. Move your mouse over the generator and hold down the left mouse button to open the radial menu. Then select the Orbit command. Excellent! You are in the optimal position. I suggest you fire your primary weapon. You should now stop your ship.
That thing was an annoyance. Unfortunately, the drifters deployed a second warp disruption generator. They must be really keen to keep you around. So you're going to have to... Oh, hold on. No time for that, recruit. It looks like you're about to get a chance to prove your worth to the state. One of the drifter seekers just warped in. You need to take it out. Aura, get our trainee up to speed on combat. The recruit is no use to me dead.
Captain, I need you to remain calm. You are flying a corvette fitted with a civilian class weapon system and a civilian afterburner for rapid maneuvering. This gives you a significant chance of success when pitted against a single seeker. Just like with the generator, locate the Circadian seeker on your overview and select Approach from the radial menu. To lock your weapon system on the seeker, hold down your left mouse button on it and select Lock Target from the radial menu. Please orbit and engage the Circadian Seeker now. Move your mouse over the Seeker and hold down the left mouse button to open the radial menu. Then select the Orbit command. Now it's time to engage your weapons, Captain. forget to stop your ship.
Well, I didn't expect that from an untrained rookie. Your first kill. Having combat experience definitely makes you more valuable to the state. All right, on to the backup warp disruption jet. Oh, wait a minute. The Drifters seriously want to get to know you, recruit. Another one of their seekers just warped in. I suspect it's looking for survivors. This means that you just got a chance to double your kill record. Make clear to it what it costs to interfere with the Caldari state.
Captain, let's see what you have learned. Now select Lock Target on the Seeker. Don't forget to orbit. It's time to engage. Fire your weapons. When you have defeated the Seeker, you should stop your ship. Explore the Seeker wrecks to see if they left anything behind. Move your mouse over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents, and then click the Loot All button. Remember to get close.
I'm starting to like you, recruit, so I'll let you in on another secret. We've been tracking a squadron of Drifter battleships, and they just turned inbound to your location. I don't care how good you are with that railgun, you can't take on a normal battleship in a corvette, let alone Drifter tech battleships. They will most certainly crush you. You need to get that backup warp disruption generator dealt with immediately. With any luck, we won't get interrupted by more of those damn Seekers.
Captain, locate the backup generator in your overview and approach it. To reach the generator faster, you should activate the highlighted afterburner module. This module enables you to trade your ship's capacitor power for speed, allowing you to reach the generator faster. When you are close to the generator, you should lock target. After locking target on the generator, you should orbit. Activate your primary weapon to destroy the generator.
Carefully, we have very limited time. A Drifter battleship squadron just warped to your location. By destroying the warp disruptor, you've removed the bubble that protected the site. It would be a waste of state resources to take them on. Intelligence needs those survivors for debriefing, and I'd like to shake your hand someday. So your orders are to report to headquarters now.
Captain. Your ship is fitted with a warp drive, which is capable of bending space and time in order to efficiently displace you toward your destination. I have overridden the ship's clearance system to give you full access to the drive. Find your HQ highlighted in the overview. Hold down your left mouse button and select dock on the radial menu. You do not want to face these giant drifter ships by yourself. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Welcome to your Caldari State Flight Academy. Plenty of legendary capsuleers have started at this school and gone on to earn billions for the state. It turns out the Sisters of Eve research team had located the exact location of the Drifter Hive. We're pressing Professor Tannen for more information, but this event has certainly garnered the attention of the higher-ups. Due to your efforts, the Chief Executive Panel has spoken, and the Caldari Navy is starting to mobilize a fleet for a counterattack. This is beyond what I expected of you. As a gesture of our appreciation, the Caldari State has awarded you with a cash bonus. But for once, the money's not the best part. I pulled for you with HQ, and I've been given special permission to accelerate your capsuleer training. Because I want you to be a part of the counterattack.
Captain, bonus payments and accelerated training are quite unusual for a recruit of your status. It is an honor to be serving with you. I must warn you, though, capsuleer training is the hardest, most complicated training process known to man. Only a fraction of pilots endure it. An accelerated process is going to be very challenging. However, so far you have been performing well. The funds you received are awarded in ISK, or Interstellar Credits. This is the main currency of New Eden, and can be used for everything from buying supplies to bribing other capsuleers. I have highlighted your wallet. You can view your ISK balance there. Remember to close all windows when you are finished using them.
Recruit! Your accelerated training is going to start with a bang. One of the state's key research outposts in the region has gone completely dark. Normally, we wouldn't send a recruit to check out a black site. In fact, you shouldn't even know it exists. But word of your rescue of Professor Tannen is spread. The research outpost is a facility where the Sisters of Eve have been working with us. The Sisters have asked that you specifically find out why it has gone silent. This site is important, so you better not embarrass me. I am temporarily raising your security clearance for this mission, but you're going to have to prepare for this journey. Aura will help you get ready.
Captain, I am running different preparation scenarios. Research outposts like these often contain highly sensitive data troves that are securely encrypted. I believe it would be wise to upgrade your ship's capability with a data analyzer module. However, it seems like the Empire's stock of analyzers in this region are fully depleted due to ongoing drifter attacks. After analysis, it is my conclusion you should build one.
So, you want to build a data analyzer for your mission? Makes sense to me, but then you'll need the necessary materials to build it. The quickest way to get the materials that you need for this is going to be to raid the coffers of the local pirates. Those guys make me sick. They are parasites on our economy. We recently acquired coordinates for a pirate asteroid colony. I think it's time that you prove to me that you will not tolerate such infractions against the Caldari state. Mind you, if you profit a little bit while you're at it, even better. Remember the creed. The Caldari don't deal in pocket change. The Caldari buy worlds.
Captain, it should come as no surprise that a pirate colony can be a dangerous place to enter alone. Might I suggest an upgrade to your vessel? You have been issued a repair module you can fit on your ship. Additionally, you can improve the effect of your existing afterburner module by training a skill. An acceleration control skill book has also been issued to you for this purpose. Skill training is vital for your progression in New Eden, and the skills you choose will prepare you for your path in the stars. You can view your current skills by opening the highlighted character sheet. You should now retrieve the new module and skill book from your redeemable items by clicking on the highlighted Neocom menu, hovering to inventory, and clicking Redeem Items. Once there, you can click on the items and select Redeem Selected Items. The items will now be in your inventory in the station's item hangar. This is where all of your modules and items will be stored. The ship hangar will display all of your ships at the current location. You now have the repair module in your inventory ready for use. To view it, open the highlighted inventory window from the Neocom and select the item hangar. To train a new skill, simply drag its skill book from your item hangar into your training queue. You can queue up additional training or train skills you've learned to the next level by hovering over them and selecting Add to Queue. Skill training occurs over time regardless of what you may be doing. You should now drag the Acceleration Control skill book in your item hangar to the top of the training queue. Now you should upgrade your ship by fitting the repair module to it. To do this, right-click on the module and select Fit to Active Ship. To see what you have fitted on your ship currently, you should click on the ship fitting icon now highlighted. Captain, your Corvette-class ship is now equipped with a repair module, an afterburner for speed, and a civilian weapon system for dealing damage. I now calculate your combat odds against a moderate-sized pirate gang to be at an acceptable level. As the pirates are outlaws in New Eden, there are bounties on their heads. Captain, proceed to neutralize those pirates and earn those bounties. I have highlighted the undock option for you. You should press this when you wish to leave the station and travel the stars. I have calculated the location of the nearest pirate outpost. You should now click on the location marker icon in the info panel. Warp drive active. Captain, I had calculated your combat odds to be within an acceptable level of safety. However, I did not anticipate the presence of corrosive gases in this area. If you get caught in a gas cloud, your ship will start taking damage. In that case, You should use your afterburner and burn through the cloud to get out as fast as possible. Also remember that you can use your repair module should you take damage to your ship, which you likely will. Captain, there are a lot more pirates than I predicted, but I know you can do this. Remember your training. Approach. Lock. Orbit. Shoot. Thank you. Great job, Captain. I have highlighted the container you need to approach. You should loot its contents, and then return to station. Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to dock at your HQ. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Recruit, the way you dealt with the pirates has impressed me. Not only did you eliminate them all, but you also reclaimed valuable materials. Now, test your skills as an industrialist and create something of value from those materials you just recovered.
Captain, industry jobs are the Capsuleer's way of manufacturing goods for himself. They can be a path to great wealth if you hone your industry skills. You should now have the materials to start production of the data analyzer unit for your upcoming reconnaissance mission to the research facility. I have calculated this to be important. To build this module, you'll first need a data analyzer blueprint, which you can buy from the market with your ISK. You should open the highlighted market tab and use the search functionality to find civilian data analyzer blueprint. Once you have located the item, you should click on it to view the active sell orders. Locate one from the list that says it's available in this station, then right-click and buy. You should now right-click on your ship in the station and select Open Cargo Hold. You can use the right-click, select All, to highlight all the items in your cargo hold, and then click and drag them to the inventory tab marked Item Hanger. In your item hanger, locate the civilian data analyzer blueprint. You can right-click on the blueprint and select Use Blueprint. This will open the industry window. Here, you can see the blueprint you are using in the middle of the window. To the left, you can see the materials that will be used from your item hanger, and on the right, you can see the output, which will be your brand new civilian data analyzer module. You should now select Start. This will start the manufacturing process. You looted enough materials from the pirate outpost to make a second civilian data analyzer at a later point. Your blueprint original lets you create unlimited analyzer modules, provided you have the required materials. Thank you.
Recruit, your preparation may seem overwhelming, but you'll be glad that you are being held to a high standard. I am about to release you into the unknown. The Sisters of Eve research outpost, critical to our efforts against the Drifters, has gone completely dark. We need you to get out there and find out what happened. Professor Tannen has asked to speak to you personally. I have approved that communication, and I'm connecting her to you now.
Captain, I specifically requested you for this recon mission to our research outpost. I had to push this all the way to the board of directors. I was adamant that the Sisters would not be of any further assistance if they would not grant me this request. The truth is, Captain, that this outpost is very important. More important than Fleet Commander Katara realizes. In all honesty, there are few people I can trust these days. The Empire's relationship with the Sisters of Eve has been tense in the past. You saved my life, however, and I feel that I can trust you.
Captain, it seems you are making some intriguing and influential friends. Your next journey will be a little longer than any you have undertaken in the past. The research outpost is one jump from our present position. That means that to get there, you will need to jump through a stargate. Along the way, many humans enjoy reflecting on the beauty of the cosmos and report feelings of tranquility and wonder, especially in advance of potentially life-threatening situations, such as our current mission. No recruit in your position has been allowed to travel this far or use the stargates. If you become a Capsuleer, you can travel to the deepest sections of low-sec space, hunt for wormholes, or travel with friendly fleets through stargates. Captain, your civilian data analyzer is now ready. You should open the highlighted industry window, select the Jobs tab, and click Deliver. The module will now be in your inventory under Item Hanger. Time to get that module fitted to your ship. Right-click the civilian data analyzer and fit to active ship. Now, you are fully fitted for the research outpost. It's time to undock. Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to set your destination to the neighboring system. Now you should select the highlighted autopilot button. This will start your ship moving to the destination system. Autopilot engaged. Once your ship comes to a stop in the next system, click on the location marker icon in the info panel. Warp drive active. This will take you to the research outpost. Approaching Stargate. autopilot jumping. Autopilot disabled. Waypoint reached. Warp drive active.
You know, you're very fortunate, recruit. Even though the Caldari state stretches across several regions and many star systems, most people never even get off their home planet. Not only that, but you are on your way to becoming an independent capsuleer, able to own and pilot your own ships. That's a very special status. Recruit, work hard to achieve it. All right, recruit. You are now in the dark. No pilot in your position has ever been allowed to enter this place. Truth be told, sites like these are some of the most mysterious places in New Eden. And this one, well, this one is well off the grid. I honestly have no idea what you're about to find here.
Captain, you should now approach the gate. When you are close enough, hold down your left mouse button on the gate and select Activate from the radial menu. Warp drive active.
Damn. It looks like the drifters really tore our fleet apart. What the hell happened here? We had no comms traffic that a fleet had run into trouble. All I know is there should be a Sisters of Eve outpost in the depths of this place. Hopefully that holds some answers. Navigate to it right now, but keep an eye out and be alert for hostiles.
Captain, this site is quite unusual, and it is enormous. In order for you to save time, you might want to activate your afterburner to travel faster through it. However, stay alert, because this is uncharted territory. The Sisters of Eve have been doing some unusual research here, which does not show up in records accessible to me. We don't know what the drifters were doing here. Be very careful, Captain. You should locate the info shard on your overview and approach it. Continue to approach the info shard. We need you to be within close proximity. Remember to stop your ship when you reach the shard.
Recruit, your telemetry indicates some strange signatures circling the outpost. But I can't get a precise read on them. Probably the Drifters generating interference. Watcher 6, you're the only set of eyes and ears I have out there.
Captain, for your ears only, I am afraid the Drifters may have hacked our outpost. That could give them access to ship FTL comms and navigation systems we've been developing. Theoretically, it might give them access to some of the ships we've installed prototypes in. It looks like our outpost is relatively intact. You are going to have to try to hack into its mainframe to extract some information on what happened here. Be careful.
Captain, if the outpost is still intact, it will have to be hacked. It's a good thing you prepared by bringing a data analyzer. Hacking is a delicate process, but mastering it can give you access to a lot of wealth in some of the deep and hidden pockets of New Eden. Let me walk you through the process. Captain, you should now lock target on the info shard. You should now activate the civilian data analyzer on the info shard. Attempting to hack into the info shard. You should select encrypted nodes until you locate the system core. After you click a node, the numbers that appear will indicate your proximity to the core. You may come across defensive software on your route. You should click on it until you deactivate the firewall. Into the info shard, you should retrieve the cargo.
What is this? These things just lit up the site. Professor Tannen, have you ever seen anything like this? Is this your tech?
No, Fleet Commander. I have never seen anything like this before. I suggest the captain get out of there as fast as possible.
You aren't kidding, Professor. Recruit, our strategic scanners just picked up a giant Drifter fleet on course for your location. I don't know what you just activated, but it's roused a flock of predators. She may be an amateur, but I agree with the professor's tactical analysis. Get out of there!
Click the location marker icon in the info panel to travel to a safe spot. Warp drive active.
Recruit, if you hadn't already pulled off a few other coups today, I'd accuse you of trickery. You've really uncovered a treasure trove here. The information that you just extracted appears to include the codes needed to activate the jump gate to the Drifter Hive. This means that if you get them to our fleet, we can use them to unlock the gate to the Hive. Oh, are you gonna be popular?
Captain, congratulations on finding the Drifter gate codes. That is amazing work. The Drifters must have been trying to link our outpost to their network through that gate. But there's something else that worries me. I navigated through some of the data when you brought me the mainframe online, and it's worse than I thought. I suspect the Drifters may have hijacked one of the capital ships carrying our prototype systems. In their hands, it poses a great threat. Luckily, the ship may be vulnerable to stasis webbing. It could slow it down to a halt. Captain, I'm gonna upload to Aura instructions on how to fit your ship with a stasis webifier the next time you're in station. That will improve your capabilities out there.
Recruit, our comms keep getting blocked by Professor Tannen. I bet she's passing on some valuable insights into the Drifters and not idle chatter. In any case, now it's my turn to show you something you're not gonna believe. I'm sending Aura some coordinates. Get there fast, Recruit. You're gonna like this.
Captain, the Commander has uploaded the location of the forward operating base. This should prove interesting. Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to travel to the forward operating base. Warp drive active. Approach the gate. When you are close, use the radial menu to activate the gate to enter the forward operating base. Warp drive active.
Behold, an unyielding arm of the Caldari state. The force that will strike at the Drifters, our fleet. Battleships, cruisers, and frigates. All being prepared for action at our Astrahoose Citadel forward operating base. All soon to be equipped with the jump key codes you recovered. With those, we'll land the fleet in the Drifters' front yard. Recruit, I don't usually do this, but it's going to take a few minutes to upload the jump gate keys from your computer core to the rest of the fleet. I suggest you fly down and introduce yourself. The way a few of the captains have been talking, you're a lucky charm, and I'd like that luck to rub off. And enjoy the view while you can. If you make naval capsuleer, you might command any one of these ships someday. I can tell you, they're a lot more rewarding to look at when you're in control. Aura, help our favorite recruit get a handle on the might assembled before us.
Is this him? Is this the pilot that saved the research crew and found the gate codes?
Captain, the assembled strike force includes several ship classes you'll often encounter in New Eden.
Damn, recruits. It took me 6 months before I posted my first confirmed kill.
You can take a closer look at any of the ships by using the radial menu to select Look At. Remember to refocus your camera by right-clicking and select Look At My Ship.
Hey, recruits! Our crew's been talking about you non-stop today.
All right, fleet, calm down. Our hero of the hour is going to stick around while we upload the key codes from their ship. Then the state has a special surprise in store back at base. The Caldari take care of their heroes. Am I right, Fleet?
Affirmative, Fleet Commander.
Captain, the upload is going to take a while. In the meantime, take a look at our Astrahoose forward operating base. It's a citadel-type structure. Citadels are the biggest structures in New Eden that capsuleers can build. These massive cities are quite the sight to look at. Since you have to kill some time while the key codes are uploading to the fleet, you have a perfect opportunity to practice some of your maneuvering skills. You can try manual piloting by double-clicking anywhere in space, or you can use the arrow keys on your keyboard for a unique piloting experience.
All right, recruit. The upload is complete and the fleet is almost ready for battle. But while the last preparation steps are going down, I'm going to suggest you skip back to base and pick up that special something I was talking about a minute ago. Sounds good, doesn't it? Trust me, it's better than you think.
When you are ready, fly to the forward point, next to the Dreadnought class vessel. When you are ready to return to HQ, click on the location marker icon in the info panel. Now turn your autopilot on. Autopilot engaged. When you reach your destination and the autopilot switches off, click on the location marker icon in the info drive to dock at HQ. Approaching Stargate. Autopilot jumping. Autopilot disabled. Waypoint reached. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Recruit, I have very high standards for my trainees, and you have repeatedly exceeded them. I have thus decided to greenlight you for participation in the counter-strike against the Drifters. Operation Black Edge. Consider this your final test before reaching Naval Capsuleer status. Now, I hope you don't think I'm going to let you go to battle in that little Ibis-class Corvette you've been flying around all day. No, Recruit. The Caldari State always takes care of the people who create value for it. So, I'm now awarding you with a new ship to participate in my strike operation. I think you're really going to like the added punching power it brings. I'm also awarding you with some upgraded modules to fit to it. Now, the only thing left is to acquire the skills to effectively fly your new acquisition. I don't have time to wait around, so let's speed things along with the skill injector. Normally these things would set you back a small fortune, but this one is on me. Aura will guide you through using the injector. Fit wisely, Recruit. We are heading up against an unpredictable foe.
Captain, you have been awarded with a new frigate. This ship is a considerable upgrade from your Corvette. Your new frigate gives you far more flexibility in how the vessel is outfitted. For your upcoming combat, I suggest using the afterburner and repair module you have already mastered. Additionally, you have been rewarded with some upgraded modules for your ship, including a few additional weapons. They must be very impressed with you since they have also awarded you a mini skin injector. These are usually only reserved for fully qualified capsuleers, but it is my assessment that you can handle a mini injector without major risk to your limbic system. Probably. Skill injectors are devices capable of transneural scanning and can lay synaptic patterns down in new combinations with skillbook data. What this means is that if you like learning fast, these are for you. Now, let's go through how we can optimally set up your ship for the combat ahead. Professor Tannen has advised that you fit your ship with a stasis webifier, and you should not take that suggestion lightly, Captain. You should collect all your rewards by checking your redeemable items under the Neocom menu and Inventory tab. You can move those to your item hanger by selecting them and clicking Redeem Selected Items. Open your inventory and select Item Hanger. There you will find your mini skill injector. Captain, double-click on your new mini skill injector and confirm the injection. This will give you unallocated skill points that you can use to progress your training. Open your character sheet to use your unallocated skill points. I suggest you search for Frigate and drag your Empire's Frigate skill into the training queue. When you've done that, find the Apply Skill Points button and click it. Your Frigate skill will have advanced a level. These skills will help you become better prepared for the upcoming battle. Skill training completed. Captain, it's time to use your new ship. In your inventory, select your ship hangar. There you will see you are currently in your Corvette. Right-click your active ship and click Leave Ship. You should now right-click your new frigate and select Assemble Ship. This will finalize the last preparations and calibrate your vessel so you can pilot it. Right-click your new ship and select Make Active. You have now boarded your new ship. Right-click your old corvette and select Repackage. This will remove the modules fitted to that ship and make it easier to transport in the future. It's now time to fit your new ship with modules. Open your inventory and go to Item Hanger. You will want to fit weapons, an afterburner, a stasis webifier, and your repair module. To fit, right-click on each of the modules and select Fit to Active Ship. You should then open your fitting window and ensure you have everything you need fitted to your ship. Now.
The fleet is at the gate, Recruit. You know the philosophy. Destroy the Hive, remove the threat. With the Drifters pushed back, the mega-corporations of the Caldari state can secure trade routes, continue expanding the economy, and establish a proper military deterrent to the Galante Federation. We are hoping that we will learn more about the Drifters in this attack, and figure out why they have been attacking us and removing the survivors. We've lost too many fine patriots already.
You should now undock and click on the location marker icon in the info panel, and then activate your autopilot. When you reach your destination, click on the next location marker in the info panel to travel to the site. Warping to Stargate. Warp drive active. Approaching Stargate. Autopilot jumping. Warping to Stargate. Warp drive active. Approaching Stargate. Autopilot jumping. Active. Approaching Stargate. Autopilot jumping. Autopilot disabled. Waypoint reached. Warp drive active.
All right, recruit. This is the gate, the spatial rift, that leads to the Drifter Hive. Our fleet just jumped in minutes ago, so expect some friendly company. You're gonna need it.
When you're ready, you should approach the spatial rift and activate the gate using the radial menu. Warp drive active.
Welcome to the show, recruit. Attention, fleet. This is Fleet Commander Caldari. I'm assuming tactical command of the Drifter Strike Force Colony Fleet. Listen up, Capsuleers. Here's the situation. The Drifter fleet is counterattacking from positions around the periphery. If you miss the massive, spiked, round-looking thing, let me be the first to introduce you to the Hive. It's pumping out the Drifter Seekers like a new Caldari megafactory, and I doubt we can stop it until we break through the perimeter defenses. Recruit! What are you waiting for? You know the drill. Approach, lock, orbit, destroy. Start handling those seekers. At this point, I need you to leave the battleships to our hammers.
Now it's time to engage your weapons, Captain.
So the plan is this. We will take out their fleet to clear a path to the Hive. Battleship wings, you are hammers that will break their lines apart. Cruisers, support the flanks of the big boys and be ready to provide ECM support. Frigates, I need your dogfighting skills. You guys have to keep any seekers or drones off the backs of the battleships and their support. Every shot will count in this battle, and I need every ship in the fight for as long as possible. Follow the lead of your commanders and maintain fire discipline.
Affirmative, Fleet Commander.
What the hell is this place? They seem to be assembling some abominations? And they're using our people as parts? We better eliminate these degenerates. This is just beyond disturbing.
Fleet Commander, we are intercepting transmissions from the Hive to the fleet.
Recruit, come in. The Sisters of Eve Research Outpost was developing sophisticated FTL communications technology. And around the time the facility went dark, we lost communications with the CNS market forces. I should have seen this coming. This is what they were doing at that outpost.
Fleet Commander, are you seeing this? Isn't this the CNS market forces that just entered the site? Isn't that the ship that went missing a few days ago?
It looks pretty different, but that's definitely the market forces. I served in the same wing as that ship.
Fleet Commander, the CNS market forces is on a heading for the Drifter fleet. Might be the Drifters have taken it over and done something to it? How did they take over our ships, Commander Katara?
Recruit, I need you to intercept the capital ship as soon as possible, and I need you to slow it down. CNS Market Forces is a Minokawa-class force auxiliary, a new and tremendously effective support ship, and it's heading toward the Drifter fleet. If it joins up with them, their formations will be hugely reinforced, and we might not be able to punch through. I don't know how you thought of it, but for some reason you have fitted your ship with a stasis webifier. That is precisely what we need for this task. Halt that ship, Recruit. It is of paramount importance.
Approach and orbit the capital ship, then select lock target as soon as you get close to it. Your web on it and keep firing. We need to destroy that ship.
squad. Recruit. Get back here and start lighting up the hive. We cannot allow it to continue to deploy these seekers any longer. Fleet, we've breached their defensive perimeter. Scanning the hive now. Pilots, once we have this data, we're burning it down. All forces find a clear shot on the hive.
Locate the hive on your overview and approach it. It's time to rejoin the fleet. Don't forget to use your afterburner and stop your ship when you reach the hive. You should now lock targets and destroy the Circadian seekers near the hive. It's time to lock your targets on the hive and fire your primary weapons.
Recruit, I've just completed a surface analysis of the Drifter Hive database. The place is literally a factory of death. Bodies go in, machines come out. They've produced thousands of seekers, and we're building up the capacity to make millions. I'm not saying this is over. But I want you to know your actions have saved countless lives. When this battle is over and the next begins, it would be an honor to have you in my fleet. Now, when this thing is brought down, the explosion will be massive. I'm going to pull back the fleet to a safe zone. I'm leaving you with the honorable task of striking the death blow. You have earned it, recruit. This will be the ultimate sacrifice for your comrades and the state. On behalf of the state, as of this moment, I, Fleet Commander Ray Katara, promote you to the grade of Naval Capsuleer of the Caldari State, and grant you full Capsuleer privileges under the Uli Convention. You've earned your immortality and independence. It has been an honor. We could not have eliminated this threat without you.
Congratulations, Captain. You have become an independent Capsuleer. This means you will now earn your own way in the world of New Eden. Your mentor would not leave you empty-handed, though. There is a new mining ship in your redeemable items, with the necessary modules to use it successfully for mining operations. There is also a blueprint, so you can rebuild the ship you so nobly sacrificed in battle. Before I fully activate the ship to your command, I would like to leave you with one final suggestion. Go visit the career agents. As you progress so quickly through your training, you may still want to fine-tune your skills. The career agents are also a great way to earn more rewards. It has been a pleasure to guide you through this challenging process, Captain. Fly safe, Capsuleer. Click on the highlighted Eve Help icon in the Neocom and select Show Career Agents. Take a look at the different career agents. Each career agent specializes in a certain field. When you've decided which interests you most, set destination to their location. The next stargate in your route will always have a yellow icon like the one below. Find this gate in the overview and jump through to move closer to your destination. You can also activate the autopilot to automatically warp and jump your ship towards your destination. While useful, the autopilot is not as fast as manually traveling from gate to gate. Once you've docked at the career agent station, you can contact them for further instructions. Warp drive active. objective. Drive active. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted. Find the career agent you are interested in working with in the agent section of the station services and start a conversation with them. Career agent has offered you a mission. Accept it, and you will begin your chosen career path. You are now in the good hands of the career agents. I suggest exploring different careers with their guidance. I will now enter standard operations mode as your ship's AI. Drive active. drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.